Assalamu alaikum, Sebastians. I'm Farah Riaz from the Arts and Design Department. Today, the information that I will share with you is about shading and sketching styles. I would like to remind you that this information is not only for you, any of your family members can also benefit from it as a beginner in drawing and sketching. As you know that shading in art is important for many reasons. First, it adds realism to a drawing or painting. Next, it gives your work a sense of depth or three-dimensionality. Most importantly, it affects the emotional tone and emphasis of a composition. For instance, if you look at this drawing of a giraffe eating leaves off a branch, you can see that the head of the giraffe is beautifully sketched with all the details of its hair and its patches with the help of different shading styles. Details of the eye are done beautifully with a darker shading style. The tongue, the dimension of the tongue which is going upwards, that is done beautifully with a shading style. And the detail on the branch which is in a closer view, that is also done with the help of proper details. As long as the leaves at the back, which are a little afar, they are on a lighter detailing side. So it is very important again to know what is the correct way to hold your pencil for shading. Today we will only be talking about shading. Detail is something that we will discuss later on. So let's start. The basic shading techniques. Here are a few basic shading techniques: hatch, crosshatch, tonal, stipple, scumble, and smudge. Please do not get worried with the difficult names. These are just simple, different strokes that you create with your pencil. Nothing more than that. So now here are some examples of different shading styles, which I hope will help you understand that what is the best style to use on a subject drawing when you are creating something. What is the best way to show the illusion of depth and to show what the texture of that drawing is, to show how light or how darkly that thing is placed. So these are all the things that can be done, that can be portrayed by the help of shading. So let's see. Hatch is done by drawing lines side by side. Since these lines are uniformly patterned, it works very well for showing wood grains, brushed metals, fingernails, and hair, to name a few. Crosshatch. This is where you draw lines that cross right through each other. It's great for creating textures as on certain fabrics or fine lines on the face. Tonal shading is used to give depth and a 3D look to work. Tonal shading is a special type of shading technique which is achieved by drawing shading in terms of engineering, which happens when you add shades of white and black to differentiate between surfaces. Stippling is the creation of a pattern stimulating varying degrees of solidity or shading by using small dots. Such a pattern may occur in nature, and these effects are frequently emulated by artists with the help of this stipple shading effect. As you can see that this natural fruit skin peachy texture can be easily portrayed with the help of this shading effect, which is done by just pressing your pencil on paper with a little pressure by creating little tiny dots. Scumble. Scumbling is a method of shading using tiny circles, sometimes called the Brillo pad technique, due to the texture of that brand of steel wire scorer. As you can see in this teapot, scumbling is done to give it a depth of light and dark at the same time. Smudge. Smudging means that you have to work less to achieve more. You simply put some graphite down and it's mirrored to cover a large area much more quickly, thanks to the resulting blurred shadow. This is the technique that most of my Sebastians use in class. All they need to do is just press the pencil hard on a piece of paper and then rip off a little piece of paper and blend it together. So this is how you get a smudging effect. Now that I hope that you have learned all the shading styles properly and you have a very fair idea for what these shading styles are used and how you can use them and how to portray different things using them, I would request you to please practice these shading styles on a piece of paper to become a master in it and to be able to differentiate that what is the best time and what is the best place to use these shading styles. Till then, I will be preparing and I will be uploading another lesson, which will be in which we will be discussing the different sketching, shading, and detailing of different subjects and how to start off your drawing. Till then, please take care of yourself and your family. Allah Hafiz.